And 20 years later, here we are. August still marks the beginning of the height of hurricane season.
Meteorologist Devon Lucie is tracking rain this evening, as well as a few systems developing in the Atlantic right now. But what's the latest there?
Yeah, so we're monitoring two areas of possible formation, a tropical storm that formed Monday into Dexter. But the thing is, that's going to stay way out to sea. So we will start with tropics first, and I'll get the WDSU First Warning Weather Doppler radar. Again, here's the overview of all of the Atlantic. And notice those outlined areas, the way that they're oriented, everything stays way out in the Atlantic over at least the next week to week and a half that I've seen the data show. So there's Dexter, and you see that that's tropical storm status, but then goes to a low. We'll explain. Moderate chance of possible formation now in Invest 96L. Low chance of possible formation shown here. What are we doing with our storm activity right now? And let's zoom out a little bit farther, and we do have our most impressive storm. It looks to be in Tangipahoa Parish right now. Get rid of that here so we can just focus on those storms. Really hefty over Roseland. Amites within here too. Fluker, Independence on the way to you. Kentwood getting some pretty hefty rain too. How about Lafourche Parish and Terrebonne Parish? We're also looking for some heavier downpours just developing earlier in the afternoon. Outflow boundaries, rain cooled air from lowlands to Donner producing these showers. And heavy downpours even farther south from here will look to be on the order of just outside of Houma here in Mandalay, so more marshy area for you. So that kind of covers what we've got for storms. There's a few in the outer Plaquemines and or outer St. Bernard and lower Plaquemines here too. What we're going to do is jump and stay focused on the tropics, specifically Atlantic. Again, Dexter being blown apart here. The thing is, it's moving into water that's not as warm, and it's going to be overcome by getting its strength from rain from cooler and warmer air mixing together. So this is by the time it's getting to hurricane status, possibly late Thursday night, that it's just a storm. It's not tropical in nature. The thing is, this goes way out to sea, so I've spent way too long talking about a storm that goes even farther away from us. What we're going to discuss, though, is this latest looks to be the 7 o'clock update now in from the National Hurricane Center. We'll see if these stats have changed. But now looking for the possibility of formation of that cluster of storms moving even farther northeast that could develop in gradual formation. But looks, and the forecast data just is not impressive with this whatsoever. And again, that moves northeast as well, staying off the coast of the United States and staying off of Newfoundland, Canada, and Nova Scotia here. So let's finally cover this medium chance of possible development, this Invest Now 96L that is just west of Cape Verde, Cabo Verde Islands. Broad area of storm activity, but it is a pretty significant, pretty strong tropical wave. We'll look at what it's gone in the order of the forecast data. There it is circled. The high pressure that's coming off of Africa is really the one that takes hold. The tropical wave here, again, doesn't show a whole lot of formation. Maybe it's moving farther north, which it does get steered away from the U.S. and even away from Bermuda due to that high pressure kind of taking it up and pushing it farther north. It stays away from us, so no immediate impacts from Louisiana or from any tropical systems in Louisiana. Next named storm, if it forms, would be named Aaron. And this just in, Colorado State University's final update of the season, Dr. Phil Klotzbach stayed with the July forecast of 16 named storms, 8 hurricanes, 3 being major. And this compares very closely to our WDSU First Warning Weather forecast for the hurricane season, 17 named storms, 7 hurricanes, and 4 major. Waited for rain today. Lutcher topped that list with nearly 3.5, just under 3/4 of an inch officially here in town. We topped out at 94, rain cooled air in 80s, but it's still pretty humid with dew points in the 70s. You got a Hammond dew point of nearly 80. 40% chance of scattered storms after everything goes away tonight. Waking up tomorrow, clear. 11 o'clock, noon, 1 to 2, the storms get firing once again, a 40% chance. Frequent lightning, locally heavy rain, gusty winds possible. We're right at that typical high for the time of the year. And we'll do it all over again into Friday. 40% chance of the storms that last through the weekend, too. A little increase in the storm chances and coverage with a little plume of tropical humidity. No tropical system. That comes next Monday, Tuesday.